Hey guys, and welcome back. Now, if you are new here, there is all sorts of fun stuff going on. I like to make videos geared towards styling tips, different styling aesthetics, fashion, and beauty. So with each video that I put out, I hope that you guys walk away feeling a little more inspired. Now, I would love to grow this community, so I would like to invite you to like, subscribe, and share so that way we can keep the discussion going around these topics. Now, in today's video, I'm gonna be talking about the boyfriend gene. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I have had my own struggles with boyfriend jeans. I feel like it's one of those garments where it takes the exact right pair on the exact right type of body for it to look like you totally just slam dunked Jennifer Aniston's signature style. So if you want to know how to crack the code and finally incorporate the perfect pair of boyfriend jeans into your wardrobe, let's just jump straight into the video. Okay, so here's the deal. Anyone can wear anything that they like. That is the great thing about personal style. However, there are certain body shapes and characteristics that are gonna naturally harmonize with certain garments because of the way that they're constructed. And this can kind of pose a little bit of a challenge if you don't have some of those characteristics or that particular body shape when you're trying to find some of these garments, for instance, boyfriend jeans. Now, I know for me, there was a particular point in time where I was adamant about adding a pair of these relaxed, chic boyfriend jeans into my wardrobe. But every time I went into the store to try a pair on, I just ended up looking boxy, squatty, two times more wide than what I actually am. They just weren't flattering on me, no matter what brand I was going for, no matter what size. And I really couldn't understand what the disconnect was. And if I'm being honest, guys, I truly thought that there was something wrong with me. I just couldn't understand why these wouldn't work for me. But after I took some time to study personal style and study the composition of the body and understand garment construction, I really started to understand that the construction of this particular garment just did not naturally harmonize with my body's natural composition or my body's natural shapes and lines. Okay, so to better understand why this garment might not be working on you, let's take a moment to actually evaluate the garment. So let's take a look at the construction, some of the details, and the overall silhouette that you're creating with these boyfriend jeans, as well as how they're used in head-to-toe looks. Okay, so first off, the construction. So the construction is generally loose, relaxed, and maybe a little oversized. We also see that the waist is never high-waisted, so it's gonna be normal waist or a dropped waist. And we do see that the crotch is generally fairly loose and dropped as well. Okay, silhouette. So the traditional silhouette is generally pretty wide, and it offers this soft, relaxed edge. And in some modern looks, we can see that there's a slight taper at the ankle, either by design or the hems are cuffed. Okay, next up is details. So we do see that they are generally offered in lighter to medium washes. And then we do see the element of distressing. So distressing can be anywhere from just a little distressing to very distressed. And we see that there's what I'm gonna call three different levels to approaching these head-to-toe looks. So the first approach is super casual and relaxed. So we see that the boyfriend jean is paired with a very simple casual top, usually a t-shirt that offers some sort of airiness. It's a little more unconstructed. And the shoe is generally a clean and simple sneaker, and accessories are definitely kept to a minimum. And we do see that additional garments can be added, like oversized cardigans, coats, scarves, and casual hats. All right, now the next level is gonna be casual chic. And we can see that in these look, the sneaker is swapped out for a little bit more of a chic style shoe, like loafers, mules, or even wedges. And instead of a regular t-shirt, we see that the look can be elevated with a simple yet chic dress shirt. Okay, and the third level is gonna be elevated casual chic. And we can see here that the shoe of choice is definitely a stiletto. And popping on a blazer to the base look adds that extra touch of chic. It just really elevates the look. Okay, so now that we've taken a quick look at the boyfriend jean and how to style them, let's take a look at the different body characteristics or types that would naturally harmonize with the stereotypical boyfriend gene. Okay, so the first body characteristic or body type that's going to naturally harmonize with boyfriend genes is going to be moderately narrow and elongated. Now, the reason that boyfriend genes are going to naturally harmonize with a moderately narrow and elongated body or frame is A, because a moderately narrow frame is going to allow the construction of the boyfriend gene to remain without adding any extra volume or width. So in essence, they're not going to fill out the gene. And B, when your body is naturally elongated, it means that it has length. So this is really going to help you from looking squatty like me in these types of genes. Okay, and the second characteristic or body type is having a blunted or softly squared frame. And if you don't know what this is, I'll leave some links in the description box down below. Now, the reason that this body characteristic works so well with boyfriend genes is because the silhouette that's created by the boyfriend gene, just because of their inherent construction, is a very soft, blunted silhouette, which mimics the soft, blunted frame of individuals that have that body characteristic. So ultimately, what ends up happening is the garment highlights and complements and naturally harmonizes with that characteristic. Take Jennifer Aniston and Jessica Alba, for instance. Both of these women have softly blunted bone structures. And if they don't look right at home in this sort of undone, casual, chic look with these boyfriend jeans, I don't know what to tell you. They look so fitting in these sorts of head-to-toe looks. Now, regardless of your body type or characteristics, I think that with any garment, proper fit is going to be absolutely most important. But in the case of the body types that I just mentioned, I think the following should be considered to keep with the intention of the garment. They should not be extremely oversized or extremely overly proportionate, and they should have a proper fit at the crotch. So, for instance, if they offer a drop crotch, we want to keep things more relaxed fit through the hip and thigh area to remain flattering. Okay, so now let's take a look at some body types or characteristics that wouldn't naturally necessarily harmonize with the typical boyfriend gene and how we can overcome that so that way you guys can still incorporate this particular garment into your wardrobe. Okay, so the first body type and characteristic is petite and extra narrow. Now, these particular body types tend to get really lost in the typical boyfriend gene. It really just looks like they're wearing pants that don't fit them properly, they're swimming in them, and the effect of relaxed chic is completely lost. So what I would suggest for this type of body is to make sure that the jeans are not overly baggy. Go for more of a slim fit to make sure that your natural silhouette isn't completely drowned out by the boyfriend gene. And keep in mind that we can still pull in elements of these types of jeans and really put together a head-to-toe look that still gives us that effortless, chic kind of vibe. So I would suggest going with a pair of jeans that are relaxed and slim fit, but still offer some distressing, and pairing those with some relaxed tops and a pair of clean, chic sneakers. Or you can pair them with a more fancy, constructed, or clingy top and swap out the sneakers for some heels. Either way, you're still going to be creating a head-to-toe look that still conveys that effortless chic. Okay, so the second body type or characteristic that really has a hard time with the boyfriend gene is going to be the strongly curved body type. Now, this body type, what happens is you put on the gene and the hip and the thigh area fills out the part of the gene that's supposed to be more relaxed. But in some instances, there's this crotch situation where it's loose because, remember, some boyfriend jeans offer that type of construction where it has a dropped crotch. And even if you get past the obstacle of an ill-fitting crotch area in the pants, you're still gonna have this boxy silhouette from the knee down, which is not complimentary at all for a naturally strongly curved body. It's a very unbalanced and unflattering silhouette and can make you look more wide than what you actually are. So your curves end up fighting against this straight line silhouette, which really takes away from the beauty of your natural shape. Okay, so let's take a look at what would be most flattering. Now, overall, the fit should most definitely accommodate your curves and taper at the ankle. Jeans don't have to be skin tight. You can definitely play with slim fit, but just make sure that the hip and thigh area fit properly and that there is some sort of taper towards the ankle just to maintain that harmonious silhouette. Now, head-to-toe looks can include a casual top that offers some sort of waist definition, and then you can always pop on a pair of heels to really balance out that curvy silhouette. Okay, and last up here, we have the third body type or characteristics that just don't seem to naturally harmonize with boyfriend jeans, and that would be me. So it is petite, shortened length with curve and or width. Now, in my opinion, I think that this is one of the most challenging body types to get boyfriend jeans to harmonize well on. So we have this shortened frame with width or curve, and when we try to put on a pair of boyfriend jeans to this particular body type, what ends up happening is we create this very kind of squatty, shortened, or boxy silhouette. It is just not flattering. There is such a lack of harmony that it can seriously be discouraging. So let's take a look at some of the solutions so that way we can all have a pair of some version of boyfriend jean in our wardrobe. Okay, so again, fit is super important and we should definitely follow in line for what I suggested for the strongly curved body types. So we do want to keep the jean more form-fitting and try to accomplish tapering at the ankle. But we can keep elements like the distressing and the wash of the jean. I think at the end of the day though, what we're aiming to do is to create a head-to-toe look that's more of this boyfriend jean casual chic than actually going for the boyfriend jean silhouette. So we want to keep in mind the aesthetic that we see in overall head-to-toe looks using these boyfriend jeans and really just go for a look that conveys relaxed chic. So we can easily do this by bringing in other casual elements like relaxed tops, casual sneakers, flats, casual hats, coats, etc. Okay, so there are a ton of ways that boyfriend jeans can be styled, and I'm not a believer that any particular garment is off limits for any sort of body type, but I do believe that there's a way that we can approach it where we can optimize the balance and bring harmony. So that is it for today. If you guys have any questions or want to spark a conversation, I would love to meet you in the comment section down below. Again, I would really appreciate if you guys liked, subscribed, and shared this, and I will see you all at the next video. Bye!